Meteorologist Dan Cianco. We had some shakes earlier today in that area of Big Sur.
Yeah, right in that area, there was a magnitude 3.5 earthquake, epicentered really just right in Lucia at around 2:42 this afternoon. It was preceded by a 2.8 and then followed by a 2.8 and 2.4 within that hour. So four earthquakes above a 1.0 anyway in that region, all in a short amount of time. It's really at the edge of the San Simeon Fault Zone, which does stretch down south along the coast. But you may have felt it. Some folks all the way over in the Salinas Valley did report feeling it. It was about 27 miles southwest of King City or 45 miles south-southeast of Monterey. Again, that was at 2:42 p.m. It was fairly shallow at a depth of around 4 miles, so you may have felt a little shaking out there. Another thing we are tracking is the heat, and we have a new heat alert to share with you. This is a heat advisory. It goes into place tomorrow morning and lasts through 9 p.m. Friday. So basically, the daylight hours tomorrow and Friday, hot temperatures expected here across the central coast, enough that for folks that are sensitive to heat, it could cause some heat illness. And while all of us are going to be hot, it's the folks that live up in the hills that will see the worst of this, because you won't cool off all that much at night. We have nice long nights this time of year, which means it allows for that cool air to develop and sink down into the valley bottoms and cool us off in the cities around the coast. But as you head up into the hills, we're in this very warm layer where you don't get those cool drainage winds. And in fact, the offshore winds are going to keep those warm temperatures blowing really throughout the night for the next couple of nights. So again, find ways to stay cool if you can. At the moment, it doesn't look all that terrible. It's just warm out there. Low 80s in Salinas, Watsonville, Santa Cruz right now. A few spots, 90s inland, mid 90s in the south. And these temperatures are quite warm for this time of year, however. We'll continue to see them throughout the day tomorrow as well. And on Friday, wind speeds still offshore. We're seeing a little bit of a sea breeze cook into the valleys, but for the most part, the winds will pick up over the hills later tonight. And again, will be strongest between around midnight or so, 10 p.m., midnight or so, and around 8 a.m. up there in the Santa Cruz Mountains. So high pressure is actually off to our northwest. It's still forcing a more northerly offshore flow for us. It's going to keep skies clear for the next 3 days at least. And if we don't have any fires to the north of us producing much smoke, our air should be okay as well. So that's the good news. But unfortunately, conditions are such that any fires that develop could spread rapidly. So we'll have to keep an eye on that. But as of now, expect blue skies. Future cast, I'm going to let it roll all the way through the day tomorrow, because we're not going to see any clouds with those offshore winds, especially early in the day. Later in the day, we'll get a little bit of a sea breeze that'll cool you off a bit on the coast, but it's going to be a toasty one tomorrow. 97 in Ben Lomond and Boulder Creek, 95 Felton, mid-90s in Scotts Valley, Santa Cruz downtown in the 90s. You'll be in the 80s on the water, 86 tomorrow in Capitola. Over to Aptos and Watsonville, another day in the 90s, 95 in Salinas, Hollister 96. Look at that, 97 in San Juan Bautista, 80s in Castroville Marina, and you'll get a cooling breeze off the water during the afternoon. The warm, your high temperatures basically be around lunchtime tomorrow. 85 in Monterey, a little cooler in PG at 79. Look at that, 93 in Carmel, and even hotter up in the valley at 98. And some triple digits on the map, including Big Sur, including King City and Greenfield tomorrow, all in the triple digits. If you're working in the Salinas Valley, take breaks, stay out of the heat during the middle of the daytime, maybe early in the morning, late at night, best time to be out there in those fields. Let's look forward to those next 7 days. Temperatures just as warm Friday on the coast, then starting to cool Saturday and cooling further on Sunday. The weekend starting warm and ending a little bit cooler. We may even see a few low clouds try to touch the coast by Sunday night, but most of the weekend will be sunny, which is nice if you like sunny skies. Next week, much more seasonable temperatures. However, there are some indications we may see some more offshore winds late next week. Inland areas will probably peak on Friday and then slowly cool back down through the weekend, heading back to normal by midweek next week.